Okay, hey Jack, this is the video for the test mix processing. So first of all, I have this enhanced data analysis software open. So I go to the left here, to the folder where we have the test mix file. And then I uploaded one of the test mix file, which brings to this window where we have the chromatograms of all these products that have been included in the test mix. So basically, test mix has a mixture of almost 17 compounds, which we are supposed to figure out the peak areas, the retention times. So, for example, one peak here, the first one here is the 3.176 peak, where we can just double right click so that you get the window that has the peak fragments. And we have a base peak here of 94. So if you double right click on that base peak, we can see what compound matches with that peak or ion in the library, right? So right here it's phenol, that's the compound. So we can tell that the first peak here that we first got, the one with the 3.176 retention time, that's of the phenol, right? And then if we were to get the results, integration results. So these are the integration results for all the peaks available, right? So there are more than 17 right now. So some of those are not too necessary. So you would actually have to figure out which one is a not necessary peak. So probably you would be able to do that because most of the good peaks that we need are bigger in heights. So that's our 3.176 phenol. There's the start and end time with the area here and the peak width here, right? So if you copy that and then close it, and you should be able to open a Excel sheet, and then you can paste it, right? So that you get all this information from that first test mix. Or just to make sure that we know what we are doing, we can actually go back to here. One second, let me see where the test mix samples are. Wait. Okay, so this is the main file for the processing. You could probably use one as a template. So you can see here at the bottom how the files are named, the tabs actually. So you give the date, month and year, and then your initial. That's how you name your Excel file. And then if you look at the Excel itself, you can see all the compounds, the 17 compounds that I mentioned right here, and also the retention time. So you can actually tally your peak retention time that you have obtained with these times. That should tell you which one is which. And then these informations that we had right up to this point, they all come from the ChemStation, right? And then we choose one of these as kind of internal references, that internal standard. So we get the ratio of the area of each peak over the area of that internal standard. So right now, nonadecane is our internal standard. So we take the ratio of this each peak over that. That should give you this column. And then we had three test mix to work with. So I've got test mix probably 5, 3, and 4 here. So these all information are the repetitions. I mean, the steps that we follow for these three tables are the same. So if you have first table done, you should be able to get those two tables, because these two piece of information come from the two other test mix file from the chem stations, right? And then the next part here we have is the averages, right? So we do the retention time averages for all three, retention times for phenol, and you can go so on all the way through the 17 compounds, and then you get the standard deviation, figure it out for all three, all 17, and then the relative standard deviation, right? And same case here with the average, because we have the average of area for all three phenol trials. And then you can go on with all 17 compounds, figure out the standard deviations and RSDs. And then here is the area of the compound over the area of internal standard, nonadecan in this case. So for this, we have the average of what I did was take the average area over the average area of nonadecan here, right here, right? So that you get the area of that, average area of that compound over the average area of nonadecan, and you can figure it out for all 17 compounds. And right here is the number of plates, which is going to be Yeah, so number of plates here is going to be 5.54 times C37 over 5.54 times C37 over W37 squared, right? So C37 here is the TR average of that compound. And then W37 here is going to be the average width of that compound. Yes. So here the second column right after the T retention time is going to be your width, area width, or peak width, let's say. And then we'd also need to have the average of these all peak width. And then for the number of plates, you plug in those information, 5.54. Here, 5.54 times average retention time over average peak width. And then take the square root of that. Should give you the number of plates for each of these compounds. And then finally, we have to calculate the resolution of the phenanthrene versus anthracene, because these two have kind of similar retention time right here. Also the peak are a little difficult to distinguish, so resolution is important. For that we need to first figure out the retention time difference between those two. So C48 minus C47, C48 minus C47, which is going to be C48 minus C47, the retention time average of those two compounds. And then you have the average of the peak width, right? So W47, so W48 and W47 should be the average. I mean, these two are the peak width, the 47 and 48 are the peak width of, 46. So 47 and 48, these are the average peak width of those two compounds. So you can take the average of both. It should give you that number right here. And to figure out the resolution, you can actually do this equation, which is 0.58 times the Q37 over Q38, which is the difference between the retention time of those two compounds over the average peak width of those two compounds. So you take the ratio of those two numbers and times it with that constant number, 0.589. That should give you the resolution of those two compounds. So that's actually it for the data processing for this step. So you can either copy this first, the whole file, and then have your information, the new information that you have from the chem station on these spaces, so that you don't have to change any formulas or anything, so that you can keep everything constant. So work with your new numbers so that you already have the template that you need to work with, right? I'm quite sure you know how to work with the spectra now. I think one more thing that Dr. Kubatova wants us to do is to figure out the each compounds first, right, for the peaks, and then write down the ratio of these, for example, right here. So if we know that's phenol, we also have to make sure that we know the right fragments for the phenol, right? So we do 94, 83.9, 66.1, 49, etc. And you can have them vertically here. So you can circle the base peak, right, 94 right here. And then you can normalize the percentage of each of these fragments based on the 94. So if we consider 94 as the 100%, you can say 66.1 peak here, right here. So this is at 130,000, right? Or 140,000, let's say. 140 for now. And that's going to be at 45,000, right? So 140 over 45 should give you the percentage of 66.1 based on that 94 peak, right? So if that's 100%, this should be probably less than 50% from what I see in the heights. So it could be probably 35 or 30%. So you can do the math by considering 94 abundance as the 100%. So 140,000, that's the base, and then you can do 10,000 over 140,000 times 100% for that 83.9 peak. So we do that for each of the compounds, 17 compounds that we figure out. So three or four fragments would be enough. But then make sure that you have the base peak circled, and also make sure that you have the percentage of each of those main ions written in a parenthesis right after the ions or fragments, right? So I hope the video helps you a little bit. If you're not too sure what I was talking about, please let me know. We can talk over Zoom about it. But this video should be good enough for you to get started. Please print this spectra so that you can write those ions right here and the identification of those ions. Just the names should be good enough. All right. Please let me know if you need any other help. Thank you. Bye.